Good morning. Today we are going to continue course auditing 2. This lecture is divided into two parts. Part number one, we are going to have mood exercise about materiality, and part number two, we are going to discuss main terminologies in chapter 3. Okay. النهاردة المحاضرة بتاعتنا هتكون مقسومة جزئين. الجزء الأول هنحل فيه تمارين أكتر عن الماتيرياليتي، والجزء الثاني هنبدأ نعرف ترمينولوجي جديدة عن شابتر 3 اللي هو audit sampling. okay, let's start our lecture. okay, the first part is going to contain with materiality and more exercises about materiality. as we discussed last lecture, materiality is in chapter 1. We take exercise about how we can use materiality to take a definition, to take a decision as an auditor to accept or reject a financial statement, and how we can use materiality to define the material misstatements in the financial statements. Let's start with first example in this lecture. In this example, for the following scenario, perform the 5 steps in materiality process. Set primarily judgment about materiality. Allocate primarily judgment about materiality to segments. Estimate total misstatements in segments. Estimate the combined misstatements and compare combined estimates with primary judgment about materiality. Okay. Earthware closers. Net income before taxes is 3,600,000. The auditors Williams and Adams have decided that 5% of this benchmark is appropriate for planning materiality, and to allocate 50% of planning materiality to each account as tolerable misstatements. Okay, so first of all, in this example, required to perform the 5 steps in the materiality process. He give you some information, and he wants you to use this information to perform the 5 steps. What these 5 steps? The 5 steps are: set preliminary judgment about materiality, allocate primary judgment about materiality to segments, estimate total misstatement in segments, estimate the combined misstatement, and compare combined estimate with primary judgment about materiality. Okay, then requirement number A: determine primary judgment about materiality and determine tolerable misstatement. During the course of the audit, Williams and Adams CPA firm detected 3 misstatements. The first misstatement indicates an error in cash related to unrecorded bank service charges. The total misstatement of cash is 2,000. The second entry is based on the results of a statistical sampling application for inventory. In the auditing inventory, the auditor found 3,500 of net overstatements amounts in a sample of 50,000 of the total population of 450,000. The third misstatement indicates an error in account receivable. The total misstatement of account receivable is 18,000. B. Evaluate the audit finding, justify your decision. So, in this example, he gave you some information. First, he asking you to perform the 5 steps with the information he gave you. With this information he gave you about earthware, then require number A, he gave you more detailed information to calculate or to determine primary judgment about materiality and determine tolerable misstatement. With the findings you are going to get from require number A, he wants you to evaluate the findings with comparing the numbers in the information he gave you before. يبقى هنا هو عايز في المثال ده ان احنا نعمل ال 5 steps materiality process، تمام، ومديلك بعض المعلومات نقدر نستخدمها او some info some data عشان نستخدمها عشان نعمل ال 5 steps. بعد كده في requirement number A اللي هو عايز ال primary judgment about materiality with tolerable misstatements، مديلك more details عشان نقدر نحسب ال primary judgment about materiality with tolerable misstatements. في example, this is in the example, there is 3 misstatements in 3 different accounts. عندنا الكاش والانفنتوري وكمان عندنا في الاكونت ريسيفبل عندنا 3 ميس ستيتمنت ان 3 ديفرنس اكونت كاش اكونت انفنتوري اكونت اند اكونت ريسيفبل. اوكي after you get the primary judgment of materiality and durable misstatements you have to evaluate the findings comparing what you get from here with the benchmark he gave it to you. Okay, with the result of benchmark you are going to find. So let's start performing the 5 steps and answer this example. Solution. Let's remember first step in the materiality process is determine the primary judgment about materiality. How to get the primary judgment about materiality using the benchmark he gave to you. And is this example he gave you, the benchmark is net profit before tax, and he gave you accepted 5% from this benchmark. Okay, so primary judgment about materiality is going to be 3,600,000. This is the net profit before taxes multiply 5%. 5% is the benchmark or the indicator or the ratio from the net profit before tax. So primary judgment about materiality is 180,000. So this number is the maximum limit of misstatement that the author is going to accept. If the total estimated misstatement is higher than 180,000, then the author is going to reject the financial statements and ask the company to adjust these financial statements to cancel these material misstatements or to correct these material misstatements. If the primary judgment about materiality is lower than the total estimated misstatements, the financial statements, then the auditor is going to accept the financial statements. So this is the step number one that determines the primary judgment about materiality. Step number two, to allocate primary judgment about materiality to segments. Okay, and step number three, to evaluate the findings to calculate number two, how to allocate the primary judgment about that to every segment. Then we are going to calculate the durable misstatements. As we discussed in the previous lecture, durable misstatements is a percentage from primary judgment about materiality. In this example, he said that durable misstatement equal 50% from primary judgment about materiality. So durable misstatement is 180,000 multiply 50% is going to be 90,000. Okay, then we are going to evaluate the findings. How we can going to evaluate the findings? We can going to calculate direct projection estimate of misstatements. Direct projection estimate of misstatements equal net misstatements sample divided by total sample multiply total recorded population value. We have 3 misstatements. We have 3 misstatements. First, let's calculate direct projection estimate of misstatements in inventory account. So 3,500 divided by 50,000 multiply 450,000. So this is the direct projection estimate of misstatement in the inventory accounts. Okay, so it's equal 31,500. Let's now combine misstatements. In cash was 2,000, in account receivable was 80,000, and in inventory was 31,500. So combined misstatement is going to be 51,500. Let's compare with combined misstatements with primary judgment about materiality. Combined misstatement is less than primary judgment about materiality amount of 180,000. The auditor can conclude that financial statements are free presented. تمام؟ يبقى تعالوا نشوف تاني الاكزامبل الستبس عندنا هنعمل ايه. احنا اول حاجة هنعمل determine primary judgment about materiality. احنا هنحسب التقدير المبدئي الاهمية النسبية. التقدير الاولي الاهمية النسبية بيكون نسبة من هيكون نسبة من بنش مارك هو مديهولك. هو مدي البنش مارك عندي اللي هو النت بروفيت بيفور تاكسز، وقال لك ان الاوديتور اكسبت 5%. فاحنا هنجيب البرايمري جادجمنت بوت ماتيريالتي يبقى 3,600,000، هنضربها في 5% هتديني 180,000، وده هو البريمري جادجمنت بوت ماتيريالتي او الماكسيمم اماونت الاوديتور اكسبتد، وبيشوف ان زيرس لو وصلنا الاماونت او اقل منه يبقى احنا فري فروم ماتيريال ميس ستيتمنتس. اوكي طيب هنبدأ بقى نعمل evaluation للaudit findings. هنحسب الترابل ميس ستيتمنتس. الترابل ميس ستيتمنتس قلنا ان هو بيكون percentage من البريمري جادجمنت بوت ماتيريالتي، يعني percentage من 180,000 او 180,000. يبقى الترابل ميس ستيتمنت زي ما مديهوني في الاكزامبل 50% او 50% من البريمري جادجمنت بوت ماتيريالتي. احنا قلنا previous lecture الترابل ميس ستيتمنت بيبقى percentage from primary judgment about materiality، يبقى الترابل ميس ستيتمنت 90,000. اوكي بعد كده هنعمل evaluation للاوديت فايند. احنا كده جبنا requirement number 1 اللي احنا determine the primary judgment about materiality. requirement number 2 ان احنا نعمل evaluation للاوديت findings ونعمل justifying للresults بتاعتنا. اوكي طيب هنجيب evaluation ازاي؟ اول حاجة هو مديني النت ميس ستيتمنت او مديني النت ميس ستيتمنت في الكاش 2000 والنت ميس ستيتمنت في الاكونت ريسيفبل 80000، لكن مش مديني النت ميس ستيتمنت او الميس ستيتمنت الموجوده في الانفنتوري اكونت. فانا عشان اجيب الكومبايند ميس ستيتمنت لازم اجمع النت الدايركت برو او الميس ستيتمنت اللي في الكاش بلس الميس ستيتمنت اللي في اكونت ريسيفبل بلس الميس ستيتمنت اللي في الانفنتوري. فهنجيب اول حاجه الدايركت بروجكشن استيميت اوف ميس ستيتمنتس انفنتوري اكاونتس. الفورمولا اللي بنشتغل عليها اللي هي نت ميس ستيتمنتس سامبل ديفايدد باي توتال سامبل مالتيبلاي توتال ريكورد بوبوليشن فاليو. النت ميس ستيتمنتس في الانفنتوري اكاونتس 3500، هنقسمها على التوتال سامبل اللي هي 50000 ونضربها في التوتال ريكورد بوبوليشن فاليو اللي هي 450000. اوكي تمام. يبقى ال direct projection estimate of miss statement في الانفنتوري 31500. اجيب بقى ال combined miss statements عندي، فاجمع ال net miss statements in cash 2000 وال net miss statements in accounts receivable اللي هو ال 80000 وال net miss statements in inventory account اللي هو 31500، فطلع لي كله 51500. خلاص طيب تعالى نعمل كومباريزون بقى ما بين الكومبايند ميس ستيتمنتس اللي انا وصلت لها وما بين البريمري جادجمنت بوت ماتيرياليتي اللي هي كانت 180000 وانا وصل للكومبايند ميس ستيتمنت 51500. يبقى انهي فيهم الاكبر؟ كوريكت، البريمري جادجمنت بوت ماتيرياليتي اللي هي 180000 اكبر من ال 51500. يبقى اذا عندي هنا as ان الكومبايند ميس ستيتمنتس از higher or sorry is less than the primary judgment about materiality, then the auditor is going to accept the financial statement and conclude that the financial statement are free from material misstatements. Okay? تمام؟ Let's discuss this solution again. First requirement, he will ask you to determine judgment about materiality. The primary judgment about materiality, how can calculate or find out primary judgment about materiality. Primary judgment about materiality is percentage from the benchmark accepted. The benchmark in this example was net profit before taxes was 3,600,000 and he accepted 5% from this benchmark. So primary judgment about materiality is going to be 3,600,000 multiply 5% and is going to be 180,000. And this number is the maximum amount the auditor is going to accept as financially free from material misstatements. If it's equal or less, the material misstatement in the financial is equal or less this number, then the auditor is going to conclude that financial statements are free presented or free from material misstatements. Then we are going to evaluate audit findings. Evaluating audit findings to find out terrible misstatements. Terrible misstatements is percentage from primary judgment about materiality. And he said that tolerable misstatements equal 50% from primary judgment about materiality. So tolerable misstatement is going to be 180,000 multiply 50% is going to be 90,000. okay. Then I have to evaluate the findings, the audit findings. How I can can evaluate the audit findings? By comparing primarily judgment about materiality with the combined misstatements. In this example, I have three misstatements and three accounts: inventory account, cash account, and account receivable. He gave me net misstatements, or give me misstatements in the cash 2000, in the account receivable 80,000, but he didn't give me the inventory accounts or direct projection of the inventory accounts directly. So I have to calculate how to calculate the direct projection estimate of material misstatements inventory accounts. It's equal net misstatement sample divided by total sample multiply total recorded population value. So direct projection estimate of misstatement inventory 3,500 divided by 50,000 multiply 450,000. Okay, so direct projection estimate of misstatement inventory is going to be 31,500. So the combined misstatement is going to be material misstatement in the cash, material misstatement in the account receivable, and material misstatement in the inventory accounts. So it's going to be 2,000 plus 80,000 plus 31,500 is going to be 51,500. So the combined misstatement is less than the primary judgment about materiality. So the auditor is going to accept these financial statements and conclude that financial statements are free from material misstatements or freely represented. This is how I'm going to justify my findings. Now we are going to see another example. Example number two. Also, he gave me a lot of misstatements or many misstatements and ask you to evaluate the results. Okay. You are evaluating audit results for assets in the audit of reports manufacturing. You set the primary judgment about materiality at 50,000. The accounts balance, trouble misstatement, estimated overstatement in the accounts are shown next. So a table, he gave you a table with the accounts he want to find out of the accounts assets. Okay, cash, account receivable, inventory, other assets, and he give you the account balance and give you trouble misstatements and estimate of total overstatements. In cash, account balance was 50,000 and trouble misstatements 5,000 and estimate of total overstatement was 1,000. In account receivable, its account balance was 1,200,000, trouble misstatement was 30,000 and total estimate of total overstatement was 20,000. Inventory was 2,500,000. Trouble misstatement was 50,000 and estimate of total overstatement missing. Other assets, accounts balance on 250,000, trouble misstatement was 15,000 and estimate of total overstatement was 12,000. Total accounts balance, he gives a total from cash, account receivable, inventory, other assets was 4 million. Trouble misstatement was 100,000 and estimate of total overstatement of course is missing because I have inventory is missing. Okay, what is the requirement? He have three requirements. Requirement number A, assume you tested inventory account amounts totaling 1 million and found 10,000 in overstatements. What is your estimate of total misstatement in the inventory? Based on the audit of assets account and ignoring other account, are the over all financial statement acceptable? Explain what do you believe the auditor should do in the circumstances. So he gave you three requirements. First of all, he wants you to calculate estimate of total misstatement in the inventory. Then he wants you to give a decision about you are going to accept or refuse the financial statement based on the results of the assets. Third, if you ignore or accept, what you should do as an auditor in these circumstances. Okay, يبقى هنا هو مدي لك the primary and find out. You must know that primary judgment ability is 50,000. يبقى هو هنا مدي لك 50,000 primary judgment about materiality. مدي لك مجموعة حسابات assets كلها cash, account receivable, inventory, other assets. مدي لك the account balance. مدي لك الترابل ميس ستيتمنتس في الاكونت بالانس عندي ومدي لك استيميت اوف توتال اوفر ستيتمنت وعايزك تحسب 3 ريكويرمنتس عايزك تحسب التوتال ميس ستيتمنت ان ذا انفنتوري وعايزك تاخد a decision if you're going to accept or refuse these the financials based on the result of the assets. And the third, he wants you to, as an auditor, what should you do in these circumstances? Okay, let's find out how we are going to solute or how we're going to answer this example. Now let's solve the example. In the first requirement, he wants you to calculate or to get the total estimated misstatements in the inventory account. Okay, and he said ignoring sampling errors. So we are going to get direct projection estimate of misstatements, and this is equal to the total estimated misstatement because we are ignoring sampling error. So direct projection estimate of misstatements equal net misstatement in the sample, and he gave it to you as 10,000. Total sampled, and he gave to you as 1,000,000. Total record population value, and he giving to you in the table as 2,500,000. So direct projection estimate of misstatement in the inventory account is going to be 25,000. Number B, he wants you to get the total misstatement. The total misstatement is going to be the direct projection estimate of cash, accounts receivable, and inventory and other assets. Total estimate statements, its meaning, the offer misstatements, cash was 1,000, accounts receivable was 20,000, inventory was 25,000, other assets was 12,000. So total misstatements was 58,000. Okay, he wants you to take a decision to accept or reject. Let's find out about primarily judgment what materiality it's given for you as 50,000. So primarily judgment what materiality is less than total misstatements. So it was 50,000 and total misstatements was 58,000. As primarily judgment about materiality is less than estimated total misstatement, so the overall financial statement based on the assets must be rejected. So as an auditor, requirement number C, what are you going to do? The auditor should request that the client adjust the financial statements because primarily judgment about materiality is less than total misstatements. Then the auditor rejects. Okay, after rejection, he must ask the client to adjust the financial statements. If the client refuses to adjust the financial statements for the likely misstatements or the for the materiality of the material misstatements, the auditor should issue a qualified or adverse opinion because the financial statement doesn't present fairly and conformably with generally accepted accounting principles. Okay, this is if the client refused to adjust the financial statement. But if the client is going to adjust the financial statement, accepted to adjust the financial statement, then the auditor is going to give a qualified opinion after the adjustment of the financial statements. Okay, so again, let's discuss the solution of the answer of this example. First requirement او المطلوب الاول ان انا كنت احسب ال total misstatements in the inventory account. First requirement is calculate total misstatements in the inventory account. But he said in this example to ignore sampling error. So when, as we said before in the previous lecture, meaning to ignore sampling error, that total estimated misstatements is going to equal to direct projection estimate of misstatements. يبقى إذا عندي لو أنا هعمل ignoring the sampling error يبقى total estimated misstatement هتساوي direct projection estimate of misstatements. Direct projection estimate of misstatements equal net misstatement in the sample divided by total sample multiply total recorded population value. The net misstatements مديها لك اللي هو 10,000 مديها لك في requirement number 1 ومدي لك total sample اللي هي 1,000,000 ومديتك التوتال ريكورد بوبيليشن عندك في التابل ب 2,500,000. يبقى اذا عندي الدايركت بروجكشن استيميت اوف ميس ستيتمنت بتساوي 25,000. ده الريكويرمنت الاولاني. يبقى التوتال استيميت ميس ستيتمنت ذا اكاونت بالانس از انفنتوري بالانس ووز 25,000. طيب تعالى ندي decision as an auditor. Let's give a decision as an auditor as required in number B. هو بيقول هنا عندي انه عايز تدي رأي to reject or to accept. He wants you to give a decision to reject or to accept as based on the account, assets accounts, بناء على حسابات الأسيتس. طيب قبل ما ادي before I give a decision I should calculate the total misstatements. In the example he gave you the overstatement was cash was 1000 and the overstatement of accounts balance was 20,000 and the overstatement of other assets was 12,000 and you calculate the overstatement of inventory was 25,000. So we are going to calculate the total misstatements, cash 1000 plus 20,000 accounts receivable plus 25,000 inventory plus 12,000 other assets going to be 58,000. In the starting or the beginning of the example he said that primarily judgment materiality was 50,000. في بداية المثال كان بيقول لك ان primarily judgment materiality was 50,000 وده ال acceptable او ال maximum acceptable amount for misstatements. بس انا طلع لي find out that total misstatements was 58. فانا هقارن ال 50,000 اللي هي primarily judgment was 58 and 58 is higher than 50 then the over financial statements must be rejected. This is the requirement number B. Okay. As an auditor you reject. What you should do in this circumstance and this is the requirement in of C, requirement C. So you should request the client to adjust the financial statement. Okay? You have two potential options for the client. First of all, the client is going to refuse to adjust the financial statements. If he refuses to adjust the financial statement, then you as an auditor must give a qualified or adverse opinion. But if he accepts, and this is the second option, if he accepts to adjust the financial statement, then you as an auditor must give unqualified opinion after the adjustment of the financial statements. Okay? By this example, by the ending of this example, we finished chapter 1, materiality and audit risk. And now we are going to move to chapter 3, using statistical and non-statistical techniques in the audit process or in the sampling. Okay? Chapter 3, statistical and non-statistical sampling tools for auditing. In this part or in this lecture, we only going to define some terminology we as an auditors must be know about statistical and non-statistical sampling. From the next lecture, we are going to use this statistical and non-statistical sampling to calculate sampling or audit sampling. Okay? First definition, we should know what is the meaning of audit sampling. Okay? We said as an auditors, we don't use the whole population. We don't use 100% of the items. We use less than 100% of the items. So audit sampling meaning the selection and evaluation of less than 100% of items in a population of audit relevance selected in such a way that the auditor expected the sample to be representative of the population and thus likely to provide a reasonable basis for conclusions about the population. So احنا كمراجعين ما بنستخدمش نسبة 100% 100% من الايتمز اللي احنا بنراجعها. احنا بنستخدم less than 100%. يبقى الاوديت سامبلينج meaning I have to choose, I have to select to and evaluate less than 100% of the items in the population. Okay? Type. This sample must be representative sample. What is the meaning of representative sample? The meaning of representative sample that the evaluation and the results that I get from the sample must be or leads to the same conclusion that drawn if I evaluate the whole population, the entire population. يبقى representative sample meaning ان انا السامبل اللي هختارها النتيجه اللي هوصل لها عن طريق السامبل دي مفروض انها نفس النتيجه اللي هوصل لها لو انا عملت تيستينج للانتاير بوبليشن. So the auditor using and select and evaluate less than 100% of the items. These less than or these items he selected must be representative. What is meaning of representative? Meaning that if I making a test for the entire population I have to get the same results as the results I get as I test some items, not the whole items, the entire items. يبقى معناها هنا ان انا بختار عدد من الايتيمز اقل من نسبة 100%. الايتيم دي must be representative. representative معناها ان انا النتيجة اللي هوصل لها عن طريق السامبل دي is the same result ان انا هوصل لها لو انا عملت the procedures or the procedure for the entire population. okay, so audit sampling as defined in this slide is the selection and evaluation of less than 100% of the items in a population of audit relevant selected in such a way that the auditor expected the sample to be representative of the population and thus likely to provide a reasonable basis for conclusion about the population. You are going to build your conclusion for the entire population based on the sampling you selected. What is the meaning of representative sample? Representative sample is the one where the evaluation of sample results leads to the same conclusion that would be drawn if the same audit procedures were applied to the entire population. If I doing the procedures or procedure for the entire population, expected that the sample is going to give me the same conclusion and the same results. Okay? Sampling risk. What is the meaning of sampling risk? Yes, sampling risk refers to the possibility that the percentage that the sample drawn is not representative of the population and that as a result the auditor will reach an correct conclusion about the account balance or class transactions based on the sample. Sampling risk, let's remember the audit sampling. Audit risk meaning that the probability that the auditor is not going to give incorrect opinion. The same here, sampling risk. Sampling risk means the probability that the sampling auditor take, okay, or the auditor choose or select is not going to be representative or going to be represented for the whole population. So the result that the auditor is going to get from the sampling is not the same result going to have if he select and evaluate the entire population. يبقى هنا sampling risk معناها احتمالية ان العينة ان او السامبل المراجع بيختارها ما بتكونش معبرة عن نفس النتائج او ما توصلش لنفس النتائج اللي هنوصل لها لو احنا فحصنا او عملنا selection و evaluation للانتار population. اوكي؟ طيب ال confidence level بقى ال confidence level is the complement of sampling risk. اوكي؟ بمعنى ان لو السامبلينج ريسك 5 if the sampling risk is 5% this means that the confidence level is going to be 95%. يبقى 95 confidence level in easier way is the possibility that the sample drawn is representative of the population. Okay? And the auditor will reach correct conclusion about the account balance or class of transaction based on the sample. يبقى in statistical terminology confidence level representing the possibility that a given interval includes the true but unknown measure of characteristic of interest. Okay? طيب allowance of sampling risk. Allowance of sampling risk is the amount used to create a rank set plus or minus limits for the sampling results within which the true value of the population characteristic being measured is likely to lie. The allowance for sampling risk D rank, it's a rank, okay, we created between limits plus or minus the population within the true value of population characteristic being measured. يعني هي interval أو rank between أنا وصلت السامبلينج okay for example 1 million okay plus 100 this is 100 is allowance for sampling risk and minus 100 the result should be within this rank. Okay, if it's after or before this rank then I'm going to not accept. Okay, we are it's going to be more obvious after we could calculate or after we solve as in examples. Tolerable misstatement is an estimate of the maximum minority misstatement that may exist in the account balance that when combined with the misstatement in other accounts will not cause the financial statement to be materially misstatement. Okay, non-statistical sampling. Non-statistical sampling doesn't follow this meaning as an author I'm not dying doesn't follow statistical techniques to determine the sample size, select the sample and measure sampling risk when evaluating results. This in meaning non-statistical sampling meaning that the auditor is going to use his professional judgment. Okay, statistical sampling, the auditor uses the laws of probability to compute sample size and evaluate the sample results. So in non-statistical sampling, auditor is going to use his professional judgment and doesn't follow statistical techniques. While he determines the sample size or the select the size or to measure the sampling risk. But statistical sampling, the auditor is going to use the statistical techniques to determine sampling size, select the sample, and measure sampling risk. Okay? And with this lecture or this with the slide, we finished our lecture. Next lecture, we are going to start solving examples and see what techniques we as an auditor is going to use to determine sample size, select the sample, and determine sampling risk. Thank you.